everybody. It's me, Warren Spray, coach of Del Sol, and I'm with the King Kopy of High School Jesters to let you know that the awards aren't done. I don't know if you've had as much fun as I have listening to all of the exciting awards for, or nominees, I should say, for our Rookie of the Year Award, our Most Improved Player Award, and our Most Valuable Player Award. Gave us all the feels, gave me plenty of the feels, for sure. But today, we're going to break down a very interesting list, another cool list, because Kopy's addicted to giving opportunities to give love to you guys for your awesome performances during the year. And one of the reasons, or one of the ways that he gives that love is through a main stage cast list. Now, he's going to break down what that means for you, and I'm going to let him do that. Kopy, tell us what these main stage cast lists are, and which one of the two lists are we going over today?
Yeah. So all sports have a varying name for what they do with this, basically. Mm-hmm. An all-American team, an all-pro team. And it's different than an all-star team in every sport. So essentially every league picks who is the best of the best, that if they can make a magical team out of all the top pros, whatever they call it in each individual sport,
right,
they would do that. Now, in our sport, essentially, who would we put in a show if we needed to cast a show and go right on the Las Vegas Strip, go record for a TV show? Mm-hmm. Who would be the students that I would make teams out of? And we do a first team and a second team, yes, as all sports do as well. So we're going to go over the second team today.
Okay.
So just the same way that you might have a first string and a second string, think of it in that vein. But essentially, these are the top 22 students that Kopy would go take to the Las Vegas Strip right now when someone gives me money.
There you go, guys. You're all stars. That's not to be confused with all stars. You're all individually stars on this list. And the second team, I mean, think about it, friends. There's, like, in the NBA, I know NBA is a sport I love the most. I mean, Damian Lillard, that killer from Portland, you know, he's always on the second team main stage. And he's a killer. He shoots threes from the logo, yo. So let's put that into perspective. Maybe you're a logo shooter who's going to make this list, and you should be proud of it because it's an awesome thing. It's nothing to look down on to be on second versus first, because honestly, most of the time it's just because we're so crammed with awesome talent. We know that over years and years of watching this list get put together. I love watching whom get the nods in this list, because a lot of them are like those really fun, like, personalities that we remember during the year consistently for their effort and their fun and just how much they really helped contribute awesome moments to what we put together. And this year, that's super important. All the content you guys did, all of the creativity from left and right field, like, there could be editors in this list. There could be, you know, those of you who used your backgrounds really clever or your props really clever. There could be some really important and imaginative minds, but more importantly, you're the ones who added so much value to your content. So, Kopy, I know there's no honorable mentions. This is 10 students here?
12.
12. Yay. The number grows and grows. Let's find out who your baker's dozen. That's 13. Your dozen second main stage cast members would be. I'm so excited.
So just to clear up and clarify, so this is not the all-star selections.
No.
The all-star selections will be revealed in 2 days from now.
Right.
And those all-stars will compete in the all-star show on championship day.
Yeah.
So just want to make sure that there's no confusion there. And for these 12 that I'm going to talk about right now, for the second team, all Jesters main stage cast, I'm going to go in alphabetical order. So just to show that there's no rhyme reason who's above the next and so on.
Yes.
So alphabetical order, I have to start with Spring Valley performer M. Bowser.
Yay, M. We've been singing your praises over the last couple of days, and now another reason for you to believe in yourself just that much more. Very cool nod. Hey, M. Hey, go back a couple days, okay? Just listen to that awesome feedback, okay? Can you just accept this? All right, we can move on. Thank you. I knew you were selfless. That's what makes you most improved. Go ahead, Kopy. Who's next?
Yeah. On before I jump there. So being most improved doesn't necessarily mean that you are the best in the league. It just means you're throwing a bunch of growth.
Right.
In M's particular case, M is legitimately swinging with every word that comes out of M's mouth. Yo. So it's a swing, it's a punch, it's a joke, it's entertaining, and M is so strong.
Scrappy. So
we recognize that I will take you to the strip to perform anytime. Keep doing what you're doing. So M, thank you. Congratulations. You deserve to be on this list.
When we bring you to the strip, bring your stool.
Bring the stool.
All right.
Next on our second team, All Jesters Main Stage cast, is Ashley Byers from West Tech.
Awesome. Ashley Byers and West Tech. Very cool. West Tech has been a powerful team all year. This is a team that's large and in charge, right? And they've got a lot of great pieces to justify why they were able to rise on up. Go ahead. Tell us why Ashley Byers bought her way into this list.
So Ashley, I started seeing towards the end of the year last year, had some amazing storytelling abilities. But kind of coated in more shyness as a freshman, a little bit more shyness. And then fast forward into this year, the shyness started to bleed away a little bit. And then there started to become these characters and these facial expressions and these contributions that would help in a big way, as opposed to just yes and from point A to B.
Mm-hmm.
So just that leap alone shows that value, and I know what Ashley's got in the tank. So I know there's just more to come, and that's someone you want on a team when you're trying to do good work.
Amen. So
Ashley, hands down, you deserve to be on this team.
Congrats, Ashley. That's an awesome honor, especially at this stage in your development. So keep pushing, keep churning. Like you said, you got plenty left in the tank. Keep it going. Keep this list going, Kopy. Who's also on this list?
Aaron Byers from West Tech.
Oh, there we go. Now I'm seeing a format here. Yes. Aaron, I remember how powerful you were in this last playoff show as captain, no less, really announcing yourself to this league and saying, yeah, of course, I can do great improv. Just watch me and begin. Very, very cool. And loved your facial expressions, really stood out to me in that game, because it's not an art we all embrace yet, I will say. And you crushed that game, and it's a great representation of why you belong here. Kopy, put it into your own words, friend.
Yeah, so unlike Ashley, Aaron did not necessarily have that shyness. Aaron almost had kind of a dude.
Chip on her shoulder.
Yeah, and kind of very forward and very willing to take a risk. And I saw towards the tail end of last year to where that courage was also still telling good stories.
Right.
What the possibilities were there. So I think that truly carried over into this year to where what in the show that you're talking about, that was Aaron's best show for sure.
Right.
Aaron's now adding some layers to that dynamic that Aaron has. I didn't want to say until now that these are twins, Ashley and Aaron.
Right.
Because they deserve to be treated as who they are because of how good they are. So I've seen it. The writing's been on the wall, and they just proved it this year. And I'm going to take them both into battle on this second team, All Jesters Main Stage cast.
Boom. Go be the funny twins. And I'll tell you, you're not the first set of twins to shine bright on a Jesters stage, but it's the first time I remember hearing two twins on the same list at any point. And that's a really fun and phenomenal first for us to experience here in year 12. And it was really cool, Aaron, to watch you give such an awesome performance in that West Tech playoff show. Somebody who understands what it means to bring out their best when it matters. Please continue that push in your next upcoming match with the very Game Valley team, if I'm not mistaken.
West Tech against Valley in round two.
What a fun one. So, yeah, great stuff, Aaron, and welcome. Kopy, keep the love a rolling. We're on our fourth now addition to this list.
A gentleman you know very well from Del Sol, Christian Cazares.
Yay. Thank you very much, Christian. Absolutely. One who has made this list before.
Yep.
In his sophomore year, question mark?
It was.
Yeah.
It was.
And
unfortunately, Christian didn't get to be in any shows last year.
Literally.
You've made a third year? Probably.
So, yeah, a crazy statistic. Christian was a very avid theatrical performer in his junior year, which limited a lot of his chances, but he also consciously chose, as one of our first vice presidents in our leadership team, to let every one of the other amazing young talents, if they could get into a show, get in instead of him. He's very selfless like that. One of my favorite students that I've ever gotten to coach, because he eats, drinks, lives, breathes what he can do for Del Sol Improv. Like, this kid, unsung hero for sure. Grateful to get to say his name in a video like this. You're a great human being, Christian. I think anyone and their mom would want to be your friend. So please continue to shine your unique light. And thank you for being my student, giving me your time, your respect, and all of your effort. We have all truly been made better by you. Truly. Thank you for that. And go ahead, Kopy. Continue to sing my students' praises.
Yeah. And that's all very evident. And if you just watch the improv alone, whether Christian is the one that has to be the high status and the wild, fun character, or Christian needs to just be the backbone and the line that transitions us into a new place, everyone that's in that scene with Christian just admires him and adores him and loves him. That bleeds through the scene work that Del Sol does. And who doesn't want that in a giant cast like this, where we're saying if we're putting the best together, he's got to be in it.
He's the heart of our team, always has been since walking in on day one. Another four-year student. Thank you, Christian, one more time. All right. Thank you. That's awesome. Thank you. Thank you. All my leaders are getting some love. Number five on this list, sir.
If you're talking about just someone who's loved all the way around, then we also have to talk about DJ Christian from Cheyenne.
Yes, absolutely. Little Hot Cheeto, as we've come to call her. A student who's best known to me as the kid who misses no improv. Zero prov on Saturday mornings from 7 a.m. waiting to open the doors at the school with us all the way through to 6 p.m. or later sometimes, because you're crazy and schedule yourself to death, Kopy. DJ's there loving everybody and what they're doing. It's just getting the most out of the creativity, but also digesting it and getting ready to throw out their own version of what everybody else does, their own awesome interpretation with their improv, and playing a really awesome role with this wonderful Cheyenne team we've been watching all year. I love the energy and spirit of DJ. Tell us more about Little Hot Cheeto.
You know, the stories you don't hear about every day is DJ's school, Mojave, as a student at Mojave. Mojave again, new theater teacher, new everything in the digital form,
right?
And wasn't able to necessarily get things organized enough to have a team. So trying to figure out how to give DJ an opportunity to play this year, I went to Coach Miley, I went to Cheyenne, and I said, you know what? I feel like there's an ingredient here with DJ that this would be a perfect marriage. And it was not long before they were friends and they were enjoying each other and looking forward to working together, and Miley telling me what a great addition DJ is and just all the positive things you want to hear when you're walking into a new situation like that, which can normally be scary. And that's a testament just who DJ's been over the past three years in the league.
Yeah.
So DJ, absolutely. You and Christian, please hand in hand, lead us somewhere, because you could.
Ooh, that's such a lovely thing to say. Yeah, if we had more like you two on the planet, I think a lot of problems would just go away. So right. Thank you for existing. Number six.
You know what? I think it's a long time coming that this gentleman deserves to get some kind of love here. But from basic, Jacob Day.
Yeah, Jacob. That is a cool name. You know, when I think basic, I think a team that is the definition of unselfish. Like, this team is so warm and affable to one another, despite such an amazingly eclectic group of minds, to me, that I'm just humbled when I watch them work together, because there's no ego, it feels. And that's a truly beautiful thing. It's high school, so no ego seems impossible to me. But Jacob Day has always been that cool, chiming voice that punches as hard as a basic student will punch in improv, right? Just is almost edgy, but is not. Never taking away, just accenting with the right amount of emphasis. That's a Jacob Day scene. And I remember a couple of weeks ago when I was workshopping a game with them, in this case, it was Naive Replay. Jacob was like, oh, I'll be coming in fourth. Thank you. Yep. I'll come in last. And just the way he said it, I was like, this kid understands what we're talking about as far as the format of the game. And sure enough, he comes in last into a game where he has to make a split decision on what's going to happen with the scene and then give a cool counterpunch, and boom, was it exactly what we needed. And then when he was done, unselfishly, anything you need, like anything I could do better, cool, no, all right, thanks, and just moving forward. He gets his role, but he gives in so many different textures, and he goes so hard, but not without humility. It's a beautiful thing. Jacob Day, what a cool inclusion. Go ahead, Kopy, thank you for that.
I mean, even freshman year, I remember him coming in, and at that time, that was a powerful basic team.
Yes.
Made it to the Final Four against Tuacon. And I remember Sydney watching him in a scene and looking over at me and going, who is this kid? Coach. Since then, that's kind of what Jacob's been doing. Just really talented, really skilled in a lot of different areas, which opens them up for the type of games they get to play. And so last year, Evan definitely, like, it was the Evan year last year, and this year definitely Evan and him just have some chemistry, but this was Jacob's year, man. He's always had it, and it's just, yep, sometimes it's a matter of timing, and it's so cool to see in his senior year that he's had the year he's had. I know they're in it in the playoffs. They're ready. Let's see what happens moving forward. But his hard work did not go unnoticed and would do us plenty of justice on this team.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. As a matter of fact, looking up and down this list and how it's forming out, Jacob will be that guy who will maybe bark loudest, but in no way, shape, or form will he try to assert his dominance over the rest of the pack. And that is a gift to have. Sometimes the loudest are the hardest to control. Jacob knows exactly what he's doing, and that's a cool trait. Good for you. Number seven, starting off the back half of this awesome dozen, who do you got?
From Del Sol, Isabella D'Angelo.
Yay! Love dragons! Isabella came to me last year and said, I think I want to try this improv thing. And what I had recognized Isabella from was from the school plays, because I like to go to the school plays, you know, the theater program feeds improv and improv feeds theater. So I'll go in, I'll pay my respect and watch them do their thing. And here was Isabella delivering a monologue and a scene. And I went, boy, what a performer. Holy cow. Like, you know me, I like talent no matter what it looks like, right? And who they are. I like watching people who are good at what they do be good at what they do. So when Isabella wanders into improv and goes, I think I want to try this, I went, well, lucky me, because I know you can go. Now all I need to do is teach you the rules and the notions, really, more than anything. And the struggle has always just been, do I really have a whole lot to teach Isabella when it comes to performing? Probably not. It's just learning the structures. And she's been amazing, right? She's been amazing. So tell us why you included Isabella this year.
Almost exactly what you just said happened to me, but in improv and not a monologue. And I think I must have saw Isabella breathe and I went, oh my God, she's breathing better than anybody. and that's about how simple it was. And it didn't take long for me just to say, hey, remember Isabella, think about Isabella, and trying to create conversation now and find opportunities. And Isabella's lightning in a bottle. And yep. I don't know how else to say it. Part of this list isn't just necessarily who's the most amazing, you know, right now and who's going to sell us out. It's someone who's going to sell us out for in the future.
Yeah.
Watch out.
Yeah. Make no mistake. The hard part this year was when you get a kid like Isabella getting as committed as she became this year. My problem was, oh my goodness, I have three starving seniors. Maybe two and a half, because Robin, believe it or not, not so much as hungry to prove themselves as the others. But what do I do with this Bella girl who's going to walk in and probably help a lot of other people who've been working with me for years go, hey, but she just got here. So, you know, so that's been my hardest challenge, is making sure everyone is valued and that Bella's valued despite the fact that I have a lot to give, or a lot of kids to give opportunities to with this amazing new star, quite frankly. So I'm excited for next year. Bella's been very courteous, respectful, selfless. That's the other thing. Let's be real about the person. Bella's stepped into some very interesting roles this year, not just for my team, but for others in a way. And that's a really fun and awesome thing for her, because she's gotten to learn more quickly. And I thank the opportunities that have come her way for that, because man, if I had a million other, or if I had just a couple more spots to give, I'd be giving a lot more to Bella. But next year, that'll be her time, and I'm excited for it. I think we all are. That'll be a really neat year for Del Sol.
And this, especially this list, the second team main stage list, this is either older students who can really dominate now, or students to where we basically have to say, hey, watch out. They're going to do some damage for a long time.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Isabella, and we're about to start a whole little trend of watch out. We're going to dominate for a long time.
Yeah. Well, I'm excited for the last five. And I will say, Bella can do whatever the heck she wants. So thank you, Bella, again, for giving me your time, your respect. You're one of those students that I'm totally not naive. You have so much. So thank you for your patience with me. Number eight.
Watch out, we're going to dominate for a long time. From Arborview, Allison Johnson.
Yeah, absolutely. Boom, beware. I've spoken before about how Allison truly did deserve to get so much praise from you leading into playoffs. And I won't repeat myself too much again. Allison, hi. Coach Warren here. Please go back a video or two and hear all of the love I have to say. And then go back to the one before that, because I had yet more. Kopy, take it away. Why Allison right now?
Arborview's team, actually, there's a lot of different people that are in and out of Arborview, different personalities, different level experiences. And Allison has seemed to find her comfort in the hardest job possible. Mm. And that hardest job possible honestly reminds me of, say, like Maya Swift.
Right.
Reminds me of what Robin's doing for Del Sol. Just the hardest spot possible. And she's doing it with ease and mm-hmm. comfort and fun. The scene there's a lot of scenes that stand out, but watching her and Audrey play that slow-mo scene where they were the commentators. If you've ever watched slow-mo, like, you've probably watched that part of the scene and went, this just isn't that funny. Watching those two, it just hilarious. Just
right. So good.
And that's just Allison sitting in her spot, doing what she knows how to do.
Right.
Being natural, being her. Mm-hmm. So watch out, world. We got a lot to look forward to in the future.
Yeah, truly one of those people who screams a complete performer so early in life. May you choose only to shoot high, Allison, so that you can find your potential. It's truly not as far as you think it is. This is an awesome time to watch you come up, so keep it up. Number nine.
Watch out, world. We're going to watch someone dominate for a long time. From West Tech, Madison Kopy.
Yeah. Yes, 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 yes. I think that it's a remarkable thing to hear that name. Not that they're going to be great, but because I'm old. Well, Kopy, take it away. That's all I need to say.
We're all old. I think that in a lot of the same ways we talk about Emmy from Durango, we're starting to have those conversations about Maddie.
Yeah.
And what Maddie's been able to provide for her team and her teammates has been just this weird spark of life that I don't think Maddie even understands yet. What makes us even more remarkable is Maddie's a freshman on this list. This makes Maddie only the fifth student in our Jesters history to make a main stage list as a freshman.
That's
only five. And if I rattled off those other four names, they would blow your mind.
Right.
So,
yeah.
The writing's on the wall. Maddie's had an effect on everything that she has done. And watch out, world. Someone's ready to dominate for a long time.
She reminds me, she is the Emmy Robinson of digital improv right now. Like, because Emmy translated what she already knows how to do on stage into the digital world, and that's fine. But Maddie's found a way to reinvent that to me in the very few examples I've seen, because we said a talented initiator, someone who's ingested enough improv to know how to make a different choice. And every choice is beautifully yet simply different. There isn't a whole lot of overthinking with these. They're just instinct. And it's a beautiful thing to watch instinct at play. And Maddie should know that the entire Jesters family, whomever has worn the J over the years, this J, that's the J, we are all incredibly grateful and proud of you. Number 10.
Number 10, watch out, world. Someone who's going to dominate for a long time. Alicia Loomis from Durango.
Yes, another young Durango says, shh, we're coming. I love it. That's very, very cool. More Durango. You know, this is a school that's taken on so many great forms, right? I feel like a lot of Durango's teams over the years have been memorable, regardless of who's at the helm creatively. You know, there's a coach named Song who came from Durango, right? There was I like Skylar. I remember Skylar. Anybody remember Skylar? Am I the only one? Okay. Love Skylar. You know, there have been a lot of really fun eras for Durango, and it's fun to see the future. It's always fun to see the future. This right students who learn the right lessons from those who came before them, make these lists and then go out there and prove it. So a beautiful thing to know Alicia is here, and tell us why.
You know, there's a very distinct, I think of anyone on this list, there's a very distinct feeling I have when I watch Alicia perform, and that's grace. There's something so graceful about Alicia's way of performing. It's elegant, it's rich, it's poised. I don't know if Alicia has any type of stressors or things that make her nervous. But you would never know in a million years watching how she performs. And then mixed into that team of juggernauts that she has, talk about just the best teammate to throw into that mix of just someone who can pick up anything and do anything. I've watched every minute, but everything that I've seen her do with everyone on her team just comes out so pretty. Every little connection, every little umbrella. How could I not want that She would stand out as graceful as she is, even in this group of strong, strong performers.
Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. When I look at this list so far, I'm seeing plenty of power, plenty of presence, plenty of charisma, and grace is not something to be missed, right? Grace and natural just capability and flow is something that you can't coach. That's something that you can only appreciate. So it's a wonderful part to appreciate of this amazing group. Congratulations, Alicia. That's so cool. Keep helping Durango elegantly transform into a new era, because we are counting on Durango continuing to be one of the powerhouses of improv, not just in this valley, abroad. So very nice, very cool. We got two spots left. Number 11
goes also to Durango, Josh Ocampo.
Boom, another reason for us to sing the praises of Durango for the same reasons. It's just so nice to hear new Ocampo and Joshua. I just had a thought. Arthur Ocampo, question mark?
Not related.
Just checking. Hair was similar. You gotta give me some
I thought of that too. Yeah.
Okay. Going back, Josh, forget what I just said. You are awesome for another, for being another student within that Durango camp that has grown and understood and learned and internalized. And now we'll get ready to personify what Durango is to become. So for the exact same reasons, I'm excited to hear Alicia's on this list. Congrats to Josh. Tell us why you thought that he stood out the most. Among the most.
So Josh, we know, is now on the most improved list for this year in that category. But part of why Josh translates over here is because of the power that Josh has. Mm. And there was even one show where Josh and Emmy ended up starting three different scenes together, where it was the two of them starting. And I remember Coach Karina asked me for advice afterwards, and I said, whoa, like the sparks were heavy watching those two just try and start scenes together because of that just raw power he has and his abilities. So, and him knowing what to do with that it's phenomenal. So mm-hmm. It's in the water at Durango maybe. Who knows what it is, but man, can that boy go. So yeah, Josh, you deserve to be here.
Super cool. And yeah, I've seen some amazing stuff come out of Durango this year. Dime Store Novel, I love that game, clearly, if you're keeping up with any of these videos. But this year they played one that saw the whole team come together. And I don't even think Josh was part of that mix for that game. And you can remind me if I'm wrong. But I am wrong or not.
Which game?
That Dime Store Novel where I keep referencing a million times. I think Demetrius was in that, and Sasha were the other two to go along with Emmy and Maya.
I think it was Alicia.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I got to know all my names eventually, right? But anyway, Josh, obviously a talented camp, obviously talented to be named upon this list, obviously someone we look forward to watching continue to develop, and please know that you should hold your head high, not only as a most improved player nominee for this year, but also as a second main stage cast member. This is a awesome thing that you should hold very near and dear to your heart. Keep it up. Keep it up. There's one more though, right?
Isn't there? There's
uno más.
And the last one actually creates kind of a neat stat. So this will be the first time that we've had four players from one team on any list like this.
Wow. Because of
this last edition. So from West Tech, we have Tabs Workley.
Wow, Tabs. And what a cool school to get that nod, that place in history. Congratulations, Coach Song. A lot of that has got to have to do with you. I mean, let's be real, but look at Tabs over here. Poise, right? I've said it already. Someone who could be in broadcasting, someone who will be, right? Right, won't you, Tabs? Won't you? That's right. Mm-hmm. Thanks for nodding. This is a really cool student because of the aura they exude, a cool, calm, and collected kind of attitude that they grew into and really embraced as the year went on, right? This came up and became a part of West Tech that just gained more momentum as the year went on. And I just like watching Tabs do her thing. I'll leave it at that. Go for it, Kopy. What do you got?
So, I mean, there's a lot of West Tech floating around these lists, right?
Exactly. So, it's an amazing thing.
Four on this list alone, Maddie, Ashley, Aaron, down Tabs. We have Hannah in the Rookie of the Year. So the thing with West Tech as a whole right now is that they're getting it from each other. And you know, maybe it is Maddie as that creator that they're watching and going, I can do that too. Maybe it is the storytelling that the twins can do. Ooh, I can do that too. Hannah's just wild commitment to everything. But in Tab's case, Tab's was someone who has loved improv, who enjoyed improv, who wanted to do improv. Mm-hmm. And I think got here and realized, oh, I could dig my nails a little deeper even. Like, this isn't just, you know, taxi cab countdown games. Or what is it, bus driver, that the teachers teach you that we don't in the league.
Right.
I can actually sink my teeth in. And that's kind of what's happened this year, is I think Tabs picked up a little bit from everywhere, and Tabs really sunk her teeth in and is performing at a high level and is funny and is valuable and needed, is checking all the boxes. So it's Tabs is having the senior year as seniors want to have.
Oh, yeah, I think so. A senior year where you find a brand new talent and you also get to excel in it. And that is super neat. Tabs, you would be the person on our list. If we were going to go start an improv variety show, you would be the one who does our weekend update, our news anchor segment, because you've got such a cool poise about you that only could come from someone who knows who they are, knows their value, doesn't question it, and is just a well of energy. And when I say energy, I don't just mean like the I mean the presence. You have a presence about you in your energy that says, yeah, you can take and draw what you want. You can have a little bit of me, but I'm going to be here still giving you me. And yep, here's a little bit more of me. I'm still me. Like, it's just an amazing calmness to the way you make your decisions and exact them. So keep it up. It's fun to watch. And happy senior year. It's too bad we only got you now, but very cool story. What a cool group. M, Ashley, Aaron, Christian, DJ, Jacob, Isabella, Allison, Maddie, Alicia, Josh, and Tabs. That is an amazing group of students. Guys, please be proud of yourselves. Please be excited to be counted among the elite of what we do this year. And know that you truly are amazing talents who will bring a ton of value to anything you pursue in life. So thank you for what you've done for Jesters this year. Thanks for the entertainment. And what an awesome main stage second team. Awesome stuff. Congratulations, Kopy. I'm putting together a crazy list. I can't wait to see what the first list is like. If these are the second. Like, my gosh.
We will watch the first team tomorrow.
And we can't wait. So tune in next time on our next Just a Recap for the first team main stage. Everybody gonna dance tonight.